ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ ప్రాంత రాజధాని రైతుల సమస్యలపై గలం విప్పేందుకు ప్రముఖ పర్యావరణవేత్త మేదా పాట్కర్ సిద్ధమయ్యారు ప్రస్తావన ఏమంటూ ఉన్నారు మేడం యు ఆర్ అవేర్ ఆఫ్ ద ఫ్లైట్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫార్మర్స్ ఇన్ ద ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ న్యూ క్యాపిటల్ గవర్నమెంట్ ఈజ్ అక్వైరింగ్ ద ఫర్టైల్ ల్యాండ్స్ ఫార్మర్స్ ఈజ్ అపోజింగ్ బట్ గవర్నమెంట్ ఈజ్ అడంపెంట్ వాట్ ఈజ్ యువర్
అబ్సల్యూట్లీ అన్జస్ట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఆల్సో అన్జస్టిఫైబుల్ బికాస్ ది మల్టిపుల్ క్రాప్ ల్యాండ్ యు నో అప్ టు థౌజండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఏకర్స్ out of the 57,000 acres that Chandrababu Naidu says he requires for the capital belongs to farmers and it is their right to give or not to give. Also there is an option available, why not go for the barren land? They want to build buildings, they don't want to grow crops for the capital. So it is very clear that they have not thought of the social and environmental impacts at all, nor are the economics of the farmers, because the farmers, they are intimidating and taking over the land in the name of private purchase or consent, but without paying money, they are only assured that certain percentage of land in a developed form will be given back to them. What will it be like? The people will have no regular source of livelihood, and taking away that large chunk of land and giving back a small chunk of plot, even if in the urbanized area, which also will not remain in the hands of the farmers forever, is cheating, and that is what they have been doing. I think the Land Acquisition Act 2013 also talks about the increased compensation, but even that they are not giving. And in any case, there should not be diversion of agricultural land and the best agricultural land, the multiple crop or single crop agricultural land, for the non-agricultural purposes, as has been happening over last few decades. Within one decade, 150 lakh hectares of agricultural land got converted to non-agricultural land. This is against the principle of food security, and so the farmers are fighting the battles. They are holding on to their land. They don't want to give land, and without their consent, no force and no intimidation and no land pulling kind of thing through a new act that they say that they have should be used, because the legitimation of that action of theirs cannot come through an act which is anti-people act.
Madam, you led many movements earlier, so what is your suggestion to these farmers?
They should hold on, not give consent, do not fall prey to the intimidation, and say that go away and build the capital on the barren land, because the land is gold, and when it is in the hands of the farmer, they want it because they want to make their own business of politics or of capital formation.
Earlier you fought against the many rulers, these type of intimidations. So what is your action plan for this? You are going to
visit action plan. The National Alliance of People's Movements support the struggle. We had sent a fact finding team. There are very good articles by Down to Earth, by Dev Sahayam, Harsh Mandar, etc. So the people of the country know the issue. It is up to the farmers to keep united, remain united, and while the legal battle is
Are you going to visit it? Yes, I am going to visit it very soon.
Long pending, as early as possible.
And one final, madam, the land acquisition ordinance is allowing these type of the intimidations?
Here they don't want to use Land Acquisition Act at all. This is an illegal kind of
new ordinance
land grab that they are taking up, but the new ordinance will also lead to more and more land grab and against the farmers.
మేధా పాట్కర్ కు రాజధాని ప్రాంత రైతుల నాయకులందరూ కూడా ఆమెకు విజ్ఞాపన పత్రం ఇచ్చారు. ఖచ్చితంగా రైతుల పక్షాన్ని నిలబడాలని ఆమె కోరుతున్నారు. ఆమె కూడా అంగీకరించారు, రైతుల పక్షాన పోరాడేందుకు సిద్ధమని ఆమె వీరందరికీ కూడా అభయం ఇచ్చారు. త్వరలోనే ఆమె ఈ ప్రాంతాన్ని సందర్శిస్తానని చెప్తున్నారు. బహుళ పంటలు పండేటువంటి సారవంతమైనటువంటి భూములో రాజధాని నిర్మించకుండా బ్యారెన్ ల్యాండ్ నిర్మించాలని ఆమె సజెస్ట్ చేస్తున్నారు. అవసరమైతే దీని తరఫున ఉద్యమిస్తానని స్పష్టం చేస్తున్నారు.